Right, here we go. Welcome back to the fourth video in the series on how to build your own drone. We're going to talk about transmitters just a little bit without getting too technical. Different types of transmitters, protocols, ports that the channels communicate on for different control surfaces, a couple of different brands, and then hooking it up to the flight transmitter without trying to get buried in the detail of it all. What I've got here is just a couple of different transmitters. This brand here is called Spectrum. It's a German brand. We fly mode one, which is throttle on the right, and then roll on the right, pitch on the left gimbal, and yaw on the left gimbal. And then I've got a couple of other transmitters here, Frsky Taranis and an Frsky X-lite, the base model X-lite. Just have a look at the ergonomics of the transmitters. So these ones are kind of boxy like, but they sit nicely in your hand. They're designed just to be, the gimbals to be the correct distance apart for average size hand, I guess. Lots of switches and potentiometers or pots here, and some other dials that move. So lots and lots of functionality there. The X-lite, students might like them because they're smaller, they fit into your hand, more like a games controller. Short stubby little switches there. The X-lite S and Pro have got momentary switches here, which you press in and they pop up again, but this base model doesn't. We've got some sliders here. The antenna in here is inside. I do have an antenna problem with this one. They break here, but I think there's another issue, and I'm thinking it's a firmware issue because it'll throw up radio antenna defective every now and then. With Spectrum, it communicating to the on different channels. A channel is just a port that it communicates on, like a line, like on the telephone line, like on line one. Spectrum is, let's have a look over here. Spectrum is, Spectrum communicates on, channel one is, it's called aileron, but it's roll. Don't think aeroplane for this, but they still have aeroplane terminology. Channel 2 is elevator, which is pitch. Channel 3 is throttle, and channel 4 is rudder, which is yaw. If you know, so roll, pitch, and yaw. But Frsky is throttle, aileron, elevator, and rudder. So Spectrum, AETR, Frsky, TAER. Remember those because we'll meet them again when we go into Betaflight. Make sure you watch the previous videos to make sure everything fits in. Okay, so we're going to be setting up a Frsky transmitter. So we'll be using TAER, where throttle is on one, not on channel three. That is important. Okie dokie. I'll leave that up there while we're talking about this. Now, with different manufacturers, they have their own proprietary way of doing things. These are fantastic transmitters, getting a little bit old, a little bit of corrosion on them, but they are really, still really, really good. These, like a couple of years ago, became the new kids on the block, Frsky, where this is like a blank canvas and I could really set up this transmitter to do anything I want rather than being locked into like the Frsky way of doing something or the Futaba way. This is, I can use these, I mean, that's throttle for me on mode one, throttle on the right, but I could actually allocate that to throttle if I want, or even that switch to throttle if I want, or that to throttle if I want. I wouldn't, but I could. I can make this play sounds and tunes, and I can just set up everything on these transmitters. Okay, they talk on protocols. A protocol is a way of doing something. So Spectrum has a Spectrum protocol. What are the protocols called? It's DSM-2 is the old one, and DSM-X, and there might even be a new one. I don't know, and I don't care. That's just how they communicate. And a Spectrum transmitter will only talk to a Spectrum receiver. Now, this is not a Spectrum receiver, but it is a receiver. So Spectrum will only talk to Spectrum. Frsky will only talk to Frsky. This is a Team Black Sheep TBS receiver. And I need a TBS transmitter to talk to it. And I'm mostly correct there. But there's just so much functionality with these things nowadays. I can buy a module that sits in the back of my Frsky. I can buy a TBS, Team Black Sheep module, to talk to that receiver. So my Frsky transmitter My FR Sky transmitter can... Just a little bit of a technical issue here, so just bear with me. We'll get this sorted out without too much bother. Okay, my FR Sky transmitter, transmitting on an FR Sky protocol, normally FR Sky receiver, but I can put a module in here. Now I've got a picture. My other, just again, having a bit of a hissy fit, but we'll fix that. The little module that fits in here, you can buy a Team Black Sheep TBS module to go in here to talk to that. And I've got one. I actually have a module that is meant for initially for the bigger transmitter, sits in here, right, to talk to this particular receiver. But then I moved across to using the little X-lite, and the module's too big, but there are adapters that you can make so it still fits into those pins. If I had the money, I would buy myself a TBS transmitter and bind it to this particular receiver. Now, what have I got here? I think I've got, I've got a picture here of those particular modules. So you can see there's an X-lite here with TBS module sitting on the back. So these transmitters here speak on 2.4 gigahertz. That's a frequency they transmit on. Team Black Sheep TBS is, I think, 915 megahertz. So it's like a different language. That's a different frequency, but it's like FreeSky speaking. What's an easy way to put this? FreeSky speaking like a certain language, such as English, and the receiver only understands English, and they talk to each other. Whereas it's like, if I've got a TBS receiver here, let's say it's Japanese, but this is English, they're not, but let's just say, as an example, they can't understand each other, okay? The receiver won't be able to understand, the Japanese receiver won't be able to understand the English transmitter. So, get rid of you, won't be able to understand that. But when you put a module on for that particular language, I put the TBS module on here, it's like, this is speak English, being interpreted into Japanese so that this can understand it. I hope that makes sense. Language is probably not a good example, but it's close enough. And the reason I went to TBS is because it's a really rock solid link. It allows me just to fly behind buildings and other things, and I don't go into failsafe because the receiver's lost communication. Now generally, transmitters are transmitting, receivers are passively listening. That's what it was like in the old days when I was a kid flying. But now now receivers can also transmit telemetry back to the transmitter. So these are really transceivers, mixture of a transmitter and receiver. We still call it just receiver, just to make life easier. Like any transmitter, you must have your antennas on. That transmitter, there's an antenna in here. Because this can transmit, I need to have my antenna on here, and my video receiver, always have your antenna on there, or else you're pumping, without the antenna, you're pumping all the energy, all that energy into nothing, so it gets stored up in the board and it overheats and dies. So make sure with your little receivers that are capable of transmitting telemetry back. This is for year 11 students in aerospace, this is a ground control system, a ground control station, and we talk about environments that missions operate in. It's not just a transmitter, it's a ground control station. It can receive telemetry back from the receiver or transceiver, and I can make judgments based on what data I'm receiving back here, battery voltage coming back from the flight controller, etc., etc. So powerful little things. Right, so let's get into rid of you, that's all good, just minimize that. And don't hesitate to contact me if you have any issues or problems, whatever. Let's get into setting up a model here so that we can bind to our receiver. So turn him on.
Welcome to
OpenTX. So it speaks to me. You can have a splash screen here. And
video antenna defective.
Yep, I know. Right, so I've got six buttons: menu, page, exit, plus minus the enter button.
Radio antenna defective.
Yeah, but just hope that just doesn't drive me crazy for the rest of my life. Right, if I hit menu once, it takes me across to my pages. I'm on page one. Okay, I'm just going to try to have that so it doesn't have a hissy fit. Right, I'm going to do that again. Exit just takes you backwards. Plus or minus allows you to select within a page. Enter to agree with what's being selected. Okay, and page, there's 14 pages of that you can select different parameters on, different settings. So from the opening screen, I go menu, takes me across to page one of 14. Yes. Right, now there's, I can have, if it happens again, I'm going to pause the video and try to
It's happened again.
As I said, these are getting really old and I'm going to decommission them and probably move right across to X-lites.
So
I'll pause this and I'll be back in a second. Okay, seems to have settled down. It's going to be an ongoing issue with this particular older Frsky Taranis Plus. So I scroll around between my models. I'm on the first page. There's 14 pages available. Okay. To select a model, I scroll up to it. So this Mycini Queen is there. And see if I turn that light off. Do I not get any? Yeah, that might be still hard to see. Bizarre. So okay, when the backlight goes off. I long hold on enter key and it comes up with select model. Notice in that menu there's also delete model and I can move models around. Go enter.
Throttle warning.
Okay, my throttle's just up a little bit, so just drop that. Yep, it's a nice little safety feature. And select a Cine Queen. There's an asterisk beside it there. And that means I can delete other models. So I'm going to go down to model 7, whatever that is. It's something I don't want because I'm not that I'm running out of space with 60 available models on here. But I could long hold on that and go scroll down to delete model and delete model 7 if I didn't want to escape out of that or exit out of that. I'm going to go to number 5. I'm going to set up a model there. And then we're going to rename it. Then we're going to bind to our Alien F4 flight control. Don't know if I mentioned, maybe, but I'll give all the different suppliers, the vendors who look after us a bit of a plug, but that Alien F4 came from, it's a brushed flight controller. It came from Buzz FPV over in Western Australia, and the Matec came from Phaser FPV. Okay, so number 5, long hold, create model, and it'll come up with the wizard. Sometimes they don't come up with wizards, and I don't particularly like the wizard, but it is what it is. The X-lite doesn't have wizard on it, but some of the X-lites at school do have wizards on them. You know, they sort of dumb it down a little bit, but that's cool. So use a plus key to scroll across, multi-rotor, enter, we'll select it. Now, there's my channels. I can't even remember if I mentioned them, but I've got them on the screen there. Pretend I have mentioned them anyway. And channel number 1, so this is Frsky, which is throttles on one. And it's already come out with channel 1 there. If I don't want that, I would enter and it flashes. And I would scroll up and change that to 2 or 3. Okay, but we want 1, so I just scroll down again. Just here, all right. These are all going to be default up through the 4 channels. Page across to the next page, channel 2 is roll, aileron, okay. This doesn't say aileron, it says roll. Other transmitters will say it, call it aileron. So page across, 3 is gonna be fine, pitch, and yaw is 4. T-A-E-R, throttle, aileron, elevator, rudder. And Betaflight will refer to T-A-E-R or Spectrum, which is A-E-T-R, aileron, elevator, throttle, roll. Okay, that's cool. You all know your things, your movements, roll, pitch, and yaw. Okay, and then channel 5 is my arm switch. So, now I always use it for arming. It's if I apply power to the drone and I throttle up, I don't want it to take off. I want it to arm it, just like a hand grenade. You know, a grenade, you would you chuck the grenade, nothing happens. You have to pull the pin out, that arms it. Any kind of bomb or ordnance or something, you know, they arm them so that they just aren't always ready to go off. Okay, I use the back left switch on here, and that's the SF switch. Okay, right there, SF. So I would go, enter. It's flashing, and scroll to SF. Okay, there it is, enter for arm. Press the enter key, good. Page across, it says beeper switch. Beeper, when we do this, I would probably, I won't do it on that one. The beeper is, like if you lose your model and it's gone into the long grass and you want to find it, you can have like a switch. The other X-lite's got a momentary switch up here. You press it down and it springs up automatically. So you could press it down and your model will go beep, 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 and you can find it. Students really like it because they press the beeper as they fly past just to annoy everyone. Just a kid thing. Something I'd probably do as well. So here have all these drones flying past going beep, 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 beep. But we'll allocate it to, let's go to SB. It doesn't really bother me because I'm not going to use it much. So enter, and then scroll to SB, enter. Next one will be mode switch. Now mode switch is, I'm going to allocate to this top right one here, three position switch. And I always allocate my arm switch to the back left hand one and the flight mode to the front right hand one. Now the modes in Betaflight are as follows. First one, stabilized mode, that will be on that position there, backwards, okay, far back. Stabilized mode is, as it says, it always knows where the center of the earth is. It's not GPS, it'll float away in the wind, but it'll do it level. It keeps it level. If I command some roll and then let go, it'll come back, let go of the gimbal, it'll come back automatically horizontal. Okay, so nice and safe. I'll tell you what the middle position is lastly, because I go straight to the third position, which is all the way towards you. And that's called rate mode, R-A-T-E, and it's also called acro, A-C-R-O. That's no stabilization at all. So if I command some, I touched the antenna, it's gonna start warning me again. If I command some roll and let the gimbal come back to the center, so there's some roll, let the gimbal come back, it'll stay there and even just go over like that, like a helicopter wants to roll over, dynamically unstable. That's acro, but that's how we fly when you're doing aerobatics and fun kind of things. And it's also, even when I'm just flying around smoothly, always fly in rate mode. You'll progress from flying in stabilized mode to the middle one, which I'll tell you about in a minute, to rate mode. And you'll probably always fly in rate mode when you get better. Because it's just a smoother way of flying. It's just much more natural a way of flying, especially with your FPV glasses on. So what's this middle position? It's called horizon. It's a hybrid between stabilized and rate. Okay, so when I'm in horizon mode, the middle part of the gimbal is in stabilized mode. All right, and then when you push the gimbal further over, it'll go into rate mode. So it's like you can fly in both modes. When something goes wrong, now I'm doing a roll or a flip, a loop or whatever, a split S, then something goes wrong, you can let the gimbal come back to the center and the drone will flick itself back to horizontal. Okay, but as I said, eventually you'll go to rate mode. So that's the three modes. We'll allocate to the top right hand one, which is called SG. Enter, scroll to SG, and that's the last one. I can't select anything else, so enter. So I get everything set up, page across, so pressing page. It just asks me to enter long, so I hold that down for longer than normal. I just check everything. So long hold on this, click it down and hold, and there we've got it set up. Right, so we're on screen at page 1 of 14. If I go to page 2, and then page 3, and then 4, and then 5, there's my four channels, my inputs. Now what this particular screen and the next one, which are called mixes, mixes is like an output screen. I'm going to go backwards, right? So long hold on page and it goes backwards. So any long hold goes backwards, any short tap on it goes forwards. That's what the controls are coming in and what do you want those particular inputs to be? Okay, in this case, they're like mappings. I'm going to map this switch, and this is my input switch, this is my input switch. What do I want to map it as an output switch? Well, it's going to be output as an arm switch. This is my input switch here. What's its output? What's it going to be mapped to? It's going to be mapped or outputted to flight modes. So if I page through to the next screen, page 6, just up here, there they are, mixes, and you can see them. So the inputs are matching up to the outputs. In fact, I found that you don't even need to really set the inputs. You can just go straight to the mixes, which is the outputs, and put them in here and specify them. And I'll show you how to do that some other stage. So there's my channels, T-A-E-R. And then channel 5, that's what I've called it in the wizard. Arm is switch SF, beeper is SB, and mode is SG. Okay, long hold on pages to go back. And notice, you know, as an input thing, the Taranis FreeSky didn't even specify 5, 6, and 7 as inputs, which makes me think you don't really need to set them up. It did them as part of the wizard. You can have an experiment with that to see what, you know, what actually is happening there. I believe you can go straight to the next page, which is mixes, which is your outputs. Put them in there and name them, and it'll be happy. Maybe it's good practice to put them as inputs, you know, to set up channel 5 back and the inputs as they come down here and call it that. But you don't need to, by the looks. So long hold on page to go backwards, short hold on page to go forward. Okay, so I'm going to long hold, long hold, long hold, back to page 2. I'm going to name this model. All right, so we enter, cursor changes. Our naming procedure is going to be, for my grade 9s, is going to be year 9 underscore and then your initials. Okay, so if you're Arnold Franklin Schwarzenegger, all caps there, lowercase year 9 with an underscore. Okay, I'm going to be Mr. B, so let's do that. Reason I want all caps for your initials and is to show you how to do it. Right, so we an escape. Notice how it goes backwards, and escape to go backwards again. You know, just to remind you on how to navigate around. Page, enter, goes to a small cursor. We start scrolling. So my aim is to see if I can find, by long holding the plus sign, or the minus on the plus sign, see if I can go close to the M. Here we go. Now, close. Now, lowercase. Actually, no, I want a Y, don't I? I want a Y, not an M. T, where's Y in the alphabet? Y, there. Yep. Okay, and then enter once. And then R, so I'm going to long hold, not long hold, yeah, I'm going to hold and see if I can get down to the R's. I went one too far, so back on the minus sign. Enter. Now the characters are after the numbers, which is after the alphabet. So long hold, I'm going to go long hold through the numbers, and it's the first one after 9 is underscore. Enter. Now, these are all caps, but there's no capitals here. I'll show you how to make them into capitals. This would be M for Mr. So, too far. Now, you long hold on enter, and it changes it to a capital and moves the cursor along. So, R, to R, long hold, and then B, long hold. Oh, I forgot to go year 9. Oops. So what I gotta do is enter, and I'll just fix that. If I escape, it goes back to the overall thing. And just, hang on. Just gonna start, dog wants to go. Okay, back again, try again. Where were we? I need to go, it needs to be year 9, so I'm gonna scroll, enter. That's gotta be a 9. We just scroll, oops, so it's all the way at the end. It went bzzzt. So we go backwards, there's a 9, enter. This has got to be an underscore. So we've got to go through the numbers and to there. So after the numbers, this would be capital M. Enter, this would be an R. QR, long hold. And then this will be a B, long hold. Even though I made a mistake, it didn't take long to fix up. So that's how you, all my Unites, will name their own models on the, in all these. Right, yeah, so escape, and then you can see I selected this model on here. If I want to select a different model, menu, and there's all the different models. Okay, and you can see model number 5, U9, Mr. B. Right, good, turn that off. Let's have a look on the X-lite. While I'm here, I might just there's other features here. Again, I might just pause. Yep, okay, back again. Just some other things while we're looking in this radio here. You know, to get across to my setup screens, I went menu once and then selected the model and then paged across, as I said. I can also get other information. I can also change the settings on the radio by going long hold on menu. So rather than short hold or short press, long press, hold it down. And then I'm on page 1 of 7 and I can page across the different pages. These are the radio settings. And this one here, I'm on page 3, is radio setup. And this is where I can turn the back, like change the volume of the speaker. I can change the backlighting. So scrolling down, the backlighting. Beep volume, how long the beach length, the length of the beep is. It's got like, you know, kind of vibration that comes up through your sticks. It's called haptic. So this has got haptic. My alarms, volume, how long that lasts for. There's backlight there, so I can turn the backlight on. How long the backlight lasts for. My splash screen's on for 4 seconds. Time zones. So they're all there. Okay, so escape out. That was long hold on menu and then paging across. Okay. Yeah, and paging across to those screens. Radio setup is an important one. You know, loading firmwares and what I call Lua scripts. If you get right into it, you know, there's just so much in these things. If I long hold on page, right, I talked about telemetry coming back from the receiver. And this makes this into a ground control station. You know, I can sort of change parameters with that, change things. I've got nothing on at the moment, so there's no telemetry coming back in. Telemetry is just sort of automatic data that comes back from your aircraft. Right, let's have a look at this one. So I've turned the Taranis off. Now, this one here, I've turned the backlight off. So this is a Frsky X-lite. And the X-lite S is the next one up, which has got these momentary switches here and here. And then there's the X-lite Pro. Some of the more expensive ones have got better gimbals on them too. Nice little transmitter. The batteries are stored in here. And these are... lithium iron. These are 18500s, 1600 milliamp hour. Okay, 3.7 volts per cell. Just like lithium polymer, 3.7 volts per cell. Positive goes up. Now, with the X-lite base model, you have to charge these separately, so you need to get a charger. But with my X-lite S, I can charge via USB. They can have SD cards in them, so you can change firmware on them, and you can put files on here that the aircraft, that the transmitter can read. Long hold to start it.
Welcome to OpenTX. Switch warning.
Okay, so there's a switch warning, and it's that one. So remember, switches up and back. Press any key. I get a file safe warning. Now we can't see here because of this backlighting. I'm gonna turn that off. So I'll pause this. And actually, I'll go into the settings and show you how to turn it off. But for the moment, because it's actually reading something here, right, but you can't see because it's just way too bright. So when the screen goes off, when the backlighting goes off, you can read. So our buttons are, we've got like a up and down, left and right kind of rocker switch here. Interesting. No trim switches, but I can use these as trim switches. And I'll show you how to do that, if I remember. We've got, this is like a dongle, a gimbal that goes up and down, left and right, and also you click it down. That's the back button or escape. And that one is that button there. I know I changed my capitals with that, I can't remember what else it is. I do have in OneNote here, right, this, which I can leave there and you can take a screenshot off it now if you want, which is all the different, which is the S1 switch and the S2 switch. I'll rip that off the internet, okay, because I need to find out what the switches were. So if I go, get rid of that, and you can see what they are. So take a screenshot of that, and the buttons are, and you can see the momentary switch is just there, 2 and 5 in this one, okay. Good skis, right, so bring you back. You back where you came from. Thanks for your patience, but it'd be good to nail this one, this little video on the head. Right, good. As soon as I move the gimbal, the backlight's gonna come on and you won't see. Actually, no, okay, that's weird. Because I had turned it off just before, but it came on and stayed on. But now it's gone. I turned it off, it's gone, so it's, which is good. You can see what I've got. So we don't have the same kind of controls as on here, like menu page, exit, etc. They're all just here. So I go, I've got this particular model selected. I go right on the, I hold hard right, all right, and I come up with my model selection. Button down here, I press it once and it goes back, okay? You can see my gimbal's there actually in that little kind of graphic that's there. Pitch your. Right, so if I just click it once like that, it takes me into just some different screens. I'm not concerned with that. Can't remember what that screen's like. It's got battery voltage and it's got. They're like trim. There's trim things there. If I go. Yeah. Scroll right. That's my aileron trim or roll trim. Back to the center.
Trim center.
And it says trim center. Pitch.
Trim center.
So what's your, I hold one of these buttons down for your, I think. Let's just do it. Because if I just do that by itself, that's just roll.
Trim center.
Hold that down. Yep, your. It has got a function, that right hand button. Hold it down, will it give me throttle? Yep. In most cases you won't wanna, you won't need to trim throttle, right? Which would be that one, because you want that to be low throttle, that to be full throttle, but we've got a jet turbine where I need to trim throttle because it needs to, the FADEC computer needs to see low throttle on it to arm it, then it needs to see high throttle to arm it, etc., etc. But 99% of cases you won't need to trim throttle at all. And why you need to trim is a whole different conversation, but you know, I guess really simply, if I'm flying along with my aircraft and to fly, it's just out of balance and I have to hold a little bit of left throttle in just there to make it fly straight. That's a pain having to hold that in. I can trim that out. I would trim left roll so that I don't have to hold it actually in on the gimbal. So with pitch and yaw, the faster you go, the more it's going to want to climb, but I might not want to climb when I go fast with my fixed wing aircraft. So I trim downwards, I trim down elevator to hold it at a certain level at that speed. Then as the throttle comes off, it will want to descend, so I'll trim back up again. Okay, 101, trimming 101. Right, so if I long hold on this, on the dongle, right, long hold to the right, there's my models, right? And there's there's the models. Now, model one is Acro B1, model two is Acro B3. They're little tiny drones. And this is JD first. So that's a student from last year in grade nine. I press down on it and I can delete that model, which I'm going to do. So I press down on the dongle and delete, press down on it and do it again, press down on it and it's gone. Don't delete anyone else's models, please. It's such a pain. Right, so I want to select that one. So now it's gone. Oh, if I want to select Acro B3, I press down on it, select model.
Switch warning.
Okay, so if I, yep, that one's up again. See the asterisk beside it? Just like, ah, the lights come on. Oh, I know why. Yes. Because the backlighting is model specific. I have to turn it off for each model, I guess, I think. Okay, so model three, long hold, because there's no model there, create model. All right, and it's got, it just does have, this does have a wizard. So you multi, so press down. Assign channel, yep. So channel, so this is multi-copter throttle. And what's my, it was, what was it again? Can anyone remember? It was T, spectrum is, yeah, it's just there. Put you there, yeah, good. It was T-A-E-R. So this is throttle. Notice how this is going to the first one, channel three. What's on channel three? Spectrum, hey. So it's following a spectrum-y kind of thing. Why? Don't know. I need to change that because channel three is not throttle. So click down, back it off, use the dongle to come. Go left and right with the dongle to channel one, enter. Right, so throttle, I'm gonna go right with the dongle. Yeah, good. Okay, so right on the dongle is roll. What's roll for the Frsky? Is aileron, which is two, so click. Scroll right, click. Scroll right, pitch is three. Tap, scroll right, three. If you get it wrong, you can just scroll backwards. Okay, stops flashing. Scroll right, four. Is your, is the same. Scroll right, enter long to confirm. This one didn't give us the options for those other things. Enter long, there it is. Let's name it now. Okay, we select it. So long hold right, screen 2 of 12, there's model name. And I'm just gonna go through them at the moment and come back to two. So there's three flight modes, four, there's my inputs, five, there's my mixes, and other things. Don't ignore that one, because that's the important one, the mixer. Okay, scrolling left, model name, scroll down. Long kind of black bar. Tap. Here we go. See if you can figure out what you would do. Okay, correct. So this one's going to be Mr. B. Correction, year 9. So if I hold him down, see if you can hit your Ys. S, T, U, V, W, X, Y. Okay, scroll right. R. You are scroll right, going looking for the numbers, and then after 9, see if this is the same. Yep, after 9 is the underscore, and Mr. B, capitals. Oops. M, I think it's this one button down here. No, it's not. That's the back button. It's probably the right button. That's cool. Tap. Scroll across, M, hold it down, see what it does. No, it just does that again, doesn't it? Tap that one, and capital, it's that right hand one. This is Mr., so this is right hand button, A, B, right hand one. Good, we've done it. Now, while, okay, that's all there. Notice in this screen, page two, I'm gonna scroll down with the, no I'm not. Because I'm still in that editing part of the name, I have to go backwards. Now I can go down. Notice I can set my timers up here. When we're flying, so important to know how long you've been flying for, else you'll trash your batteries, your lithium polymer batteries in your drone. And they're only little drones and they won't fly for long. Live with it. You're not going to be out there flying half an hour. So, you know, on some of my other drones, I fly for 4 minutes. So about 3 minutes I have the first warning. And as getting up to like 3 minutes 50, it counts down from 10, 10, 9. You know, so when I hit that 3 minutes, I start to bring it back. I just change batteries. Look after your batteries. So you got timer two, you know, persistent, you know, to want to keep warning you. You've got countdowns, you got all sorts of parameters you can set. You know, most of these I don't touch. This one here, see, it's got internal RF, right, and external RF. RF is radius frequency. Remember I talked about the module you can have on the back? That's an external RF. This has got the antenna is inside and everything's inside, so it's internal. We need to know these. Also, that thing there called BND, we'll need to get hold of when we're binding to our flight controller. And that's where we find it on page two. Okay, we'll press it. I'm not binding at the moment, but when I press it, I'm just gonna leave that channel 1 to 8 telemetry on, because if there's telemetry coming back, I want it turned on. Yeah, press it, it should chirp. Can you hear it? There's my microphone. I don't know if you can hear it. It's flashing. Press it to go off. Okay. But if I had a module in here, I'd turn internal RF off. There. You kids, don't touch it, please. You students. Right. It's been a nightmare, but you tap it. At the moment, it's D16. I remember that. But I'd scroll and go off. And then I'd select external RF. Okay, but I'm D16 channel. And I'm back to, it just scrolls from the bottom back up to the top. Okay, so I've named my model. There it is. Escape. And there's my model. Okay. If I was to go to the right, long hold to the right, you can see my model sitting in there with the other models. And that's how you'll name yours. Right, escape. So we've named our model. Now, let's hook up our flight controller to Betaflight and then bind to it. Now on the F4 flight controller, is this going to focus? Come on, big fella. There's two buttons there. Pretty sure. I'm just gonna put my funny glasses on again so I can see what it is. Yeah, pretty sure that that's like a boot button, and that's the bind button. And that's the one we need, the one near the edge. Okay, my nines have already set their mounted their flight controllers. They know which is the direction to travel. Some of them have mounted it upside down deliberately so they can get access to the USB port and get access to the motors where the motors plug in. And you just need to specify in Betaflight that if it's upside down, that it's flipped 180 degrees. And if it's not, if that's a direction to travel that way, there's the arrow, right? Some of them have got it mounted that way, and you just have to tell it that it's rotated 90 degrees, just so the flight controller knows which way is forward. Right, so I've got my USB connected here. Let me just double check. Okay. It's not connected, but I'm going to plug it in carefully without putting your fingers all over the board. Handle it around the edges. Don't break it, just treat it really, really gently. And we're going to power it up. Okay, yeah, that's okay. I plugged the wrong USB in. Have your drone horizontal and we'll start Betaflight. See the icon down here? It's a little wasp, yellowy wasp. Okay, and I might have to hide a couple of things here just for the moment. Okay, there it is. And you wait just a little while and that should change over to COM5. And I think my last tutorial had what happens if it's got that dev kind of port thing up here, and how to, you just need to load the USB drivers. So I use a mixture of ZADIG and Impulse RC's driver fixer, which you can download off Impulse RC's website. This is mounted as COM5. If I was to load my other flight controller there, you can't see, but it would mount it as COM6. Okay, so COM5, it's gonna connect. And there it is. I move it. I might, because I can, I might put the razor back up here, make him a little bit smaller. And just shift it over here where there's not much happening. Okay. Because everything mostly is happening on the left-hand side and right-hand side. Okay, so Betaflight. So at the moment, we are connected quite well. Now, when this is my drone, I'd calibrate my accelerometers and I'd set it all up, another video. But for the moment, we are going to bind to it. Now, in my OneNote, I have got, if I can search for this, I can. I've got alien, and I can't spell alien. F4, I've got a little thing there on how to bind. Just have a quick read, take a screen capture of that. Binding procedure reversed as usual. No need to click the bind button when power on. Power the body by connecting, I've powered it on. Green receiver LED will start to flash. Yes, it is, just there. And then I hold the bind button for 3 seconds. I've got my piece of wood that I've just shaped one end, a little bit pointy, so I can press that bind button. It should go, green receiver will be solid on. This means that the receiver is in bind mode. You can start to bind your radio transmitter. Okay, and I can press that bind button just on here. So I get this set up. So, long hold to the right, correction, go back, long hold there to that one, and then long hold again to the right. I'm on page 2, right, and then we scroll down. I'll do that again, from the main menu, just there, long hold to the right. And then across to the right, a short one across to the right to get you onto page 2. Okay, we're looking for bind. I may have gone past it, but that's cool because I don't have the backlighting on. Here we go. Right, internal RF, D16, channel 1 to 16, scroll across to bind. Right, power on the flight controller. If this doesn't work straight away, I'll just try different combinations. Now, before I do that, I'll show you Betaflight. I'll go back to Betaflight. There's Betaflight. Right, and if I come down to receiver, there's all my receiver channels. But when I move my gimbals, those little sliders or scroll bars, nothing happens to them because the receiver is not talking to the transmitter. I've got to do what this process is called binding or pairing. Let's call it binding, where I bind this particular model on this particular transmitter to this receiver. Okay, this and remember the receiver is embedded on the flight controller here, but it could be a separate receiver, just like this TBS one. Okay, but the receiver is integrated onto this board. So, so there's no response there, obviously because I'm down. So let's go to my binding procedure. Click the button for 3 seconds. You can use your fingernail. 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, it pretty much went into it straight away. Over here, click bind. Dog must have been bound. If you can focus. Telemetry on. Channel 1 to 8, telemetry on. The green receiver will be solid mode. This means that receiver is in bind mode. You can start to bind your radio transmitter. Okay, so it's starting to flash again. It seemed to have been successful, but I don't know. So I'm going to tap that one more time, the dongle, take it out of bind mode. That little red LED went flash really quick. And I got a solid green. That's got to be a good sign. Go back to Betaflight, the acid test. Okay, good. There we go. Have a look. So roll, I'm rolling left, rolling right. Pitch forward, pitch back, your left, your right. Sound like idiom I'm in. Your left, your right. Throttle. Now my aux channels. I haven't set up my aux channels. I set them up on the Taranis, but I haven't set them up here. So what we'll do is pause now. It's bound, so I'm stoked about that. That was a binding procedure. And I'm gonna pause it and have a little bit of a think, right, about something else. Okay, yeah, I was wondering, should I do the those other channels, the flight modes on here, or save it for another video. I'm gonna save it for another video because this has been long. I really wanted, you know, to be able to give you an overview of transmitters and how to put your name in them, set yourself a model up, how to navigate around, and how to bind to the Alien F4 flight controller, which is the main thing. Once we do that, you know, as I'm talking to the receiver, I can control the thing, you know. I can have my motors plugged in, I can test my motors, I can start setting up my flight modes. But that'll be another video, so we'll hold it there. Thanks for your patience. Yeah, pretty happy that everything's gone to plan. And I'll see you for the next video. Gerbs. This is Banksy out.